गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, दिस इज़ योर इंग्लिश टीचर रजनी, डीएवी पब्लिक स्कूल, डॉक्टर एनटीटीपीएस, इब्राहिम पट्टनम। वेलकम टू आवर इंग्लिश क्लास। इन द लास्ट क्लास यू लर्न द किंग एंड द मंकी। इट इज़ अ स्टोरी फ्रॉम पंचतंत्र। टुडे वी विल सी द कंटिन्यूएशन पार्ट। चिल्ड्रन, यू अंडरस्टूड आई थिंक। वंस अगेन आई विल रिकॉल द स्टोरी। The story from Panchatantra is about a king who had a pet monkey. One day, the king was sleeping when a fly flew into the room. Is it or not? The king treated the monkey like a friend. He asked the monkey to see when he was sleeping. No one should enter his room while he was sleeping. Then what happened, we will see. Suddenly, a fly came in through an open window. Suddenly, a fly came in through an open window. In the king's palace, in his room, there is a window. That window was open. So, when the king was sleeping, a fly came through a window. See, children, a fly came through a window, through an open window. The monkey said to the fly, seeing the fly, what the monkey said, we'll see. The monkey said to the fly, "Hello, friend. Please do not disturb the king. He is sleeping." The fly did not answer. It flew away and sat on a bowl of fruits. The monkey said to the fly. The monkey told the fly. The monkey called the fly a friend and requested not to disturb the king because the king was sleeping. And the king ordered the monkey, no one should enter and no one should disturb him. So he is watching. The monkey is watching. That's why the monkey requested the fly not to disturb the king as he is sleeping. But the fly did not answer to him. Simply, it flew away and sat on a bowl of fruits. See in the picture also, first the monkey is speaking with the fly, but it did not answer. Simply, it sat on a bowl of fruits. In the king's room, there is a bowl. In that bowl, there are fruits. Simply, it sat on the bowl of fruits. The fly sat on a bowl of fruits. It did not answer. Simply sat on a bowl of fruits. The monkey hit the fly with its paw and said, "Shoo! Get out of the room." The fly flew away and landed on the king's pillow. The monkey was angry. How dare the fly sit on the king's bed? Okay, it sat on the bowl of fruits. So then what happened? The monkey hit the fly with its paw. Paw, you know the paw. Paw means the monkey's leg, like that. With that paw, it hit the fly. It hit the fly. And also said shoo. Shoo means driving away the fly. Shoo. It drove away the fly and also asked it to get out of the room. But the fly flew away and what happened? And landed on the king's pillow. Landed already, give meaning is there. Landed means came down. The fly flew away and sat on the king's pillow. See in the picture also, it sat on the king's pillow. Pillow means we all know while we are sleeping we put our head on the pillow, is it or not? We'll rest our head on that pillow. That is called pillow. Okay. Now, the fly away and sat on the king's pillow. Seeing that, the monkey was very angry and also said, how dare the fly sat on the king's bed. Meaning is given. The monkey feels the fly has no right to sit on the king's bed. Understood, no children? Here, the monkey has no right to sit on the king's bed or on the pillow or in the king's room. Okay? And see. The monkey saw the king's sword near the bed. He picked it up and tried to kill the fly with it. So it cannot do anything. So immediately the monkey saw the king's sword near the bed. Immediately it picked it up. It had taken that sword and tried to kill the fly with it. You can see in the picture also there is a sword in monkey's hand. With that, the monkey tried to kill the fly with it. He missed. The fly settled on the king's nose. At once, the monkey hit the fly with the sword. Goodbye, you silly fly, it shouted. Okay, now what happened? Now the monkey had taken the sword, no, so it wanted to kill the fly with it. But it missed. But the fly missed. When the monkey was about to kill the fly, simply the fly again came on the king's nose. Settled on means came to rest on something. Simply, it is taking rest. The fly is taking rest on king's nose. Again, at once, the monkey wants to hit the fly with the sword. And also said, goodbye, you silly fly, it shouted. It asked the fly to go away from this place. Monkey asked the fly, monkey called the silly fly because it is playing with him. The fly is playing with the monkey. Even it had shouted not to be here, but it is playing with it. So the monkey called the fly as silly fly and also asked to go away. Then what happened? See, the king awoke with a loud scream. The king awoke with a loud scream. The monkey had cut the king's nose while the fly escaped. Okay, but the monkey did not understand what it is doing. Simply, it wanted to kill the fly. It is not bothering about the king. And whatever the king ordered, it is doing. What the king ordered? The king ordered not to disturb him. So, when the fly came, it wanted to kill with the sword. But what happened here? The king awoke with a loud scream. Scream means shouted. Shouted with the pain. Immediately, the king got up from his sleep with a loud shout. Because the monkey had cut the king's nose while the fly escaped. Here the monkey also wantedly did not cut the king's nose. It wanted to kill the fly, but the silly fly escaped and had cut the king's nose. By mistake, the monkey had cut the king's nose, but the fly had escaped. The wise fly had escaped. Then what happened? See, the king recovered after many weeks. He forgave the monkey but learned not to trust an unwise creature. Okay, now the monkey cut the king's nose, no? So anyhow, the king recovered. Recovered means got well. He got well after many weeks. After number of weeks, the king was okay. He had recovered and now he is okay. He forgave the monkey. But learned not to trust an unwise creature. Trust means having a belief. But the king learnt a lesson that he should not believe a silly creature. Who is the silly creature here? Monkey. So he thought that he should not believe an unwise creature. Now the king learnt a good lesson from the monkey. Understood, no children? See the moral. We should stay away from foolish friends. We should stay away from foolish friends. Why? What the king did? Why the king said like that? Because the monkey acted without thinking about the result of his actions. It did not think about the result of the actions. What happened here? What is the result? The monkey had cut the king's nose. Instead of killing the fly with the sword, it cut the king's nose. When people act without thinking, we call them foolish. When people act without thinking, we call them foolish. These people can cause harm to themselves as well as others. So it is best to avoid such people. Understood, no? It is best to avoid such people. The king had given a duty to see that no one should enter. But here the monkey understood even a fly also should not come to his room. So it wanted to kill the fly with the sword. Instead of killing the fly, he had cut the king's nose. So the king learnt a good lesson from the monkey. He thought that he should stay away from foolish friends. Understood, no children? All of you learn meanings and also read the textbook. Okay, children? Have a nice day.